Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing well. So in this class, I'm going to discuss with you that major and important problems related to Indian agriculture. As you have remembered that in our last class, in our last video, I have discussed the general information regarding agriculture and what are the basic importance or significance of Indian agriculture. But in this class, in this video, I am going to discuss with you all the major important problems related to Indian agriculture. There are so many plus points for Indian agriculture, but so many negative points as well. So before starting this video, I want to tell you that after this session, after this video, I am going to put some important questions related to Indian agricultural problems, and I'll hope that you all will solve this. So without wasting any time, let's move on to the main topic. So as I told you that there are so many negative points for Indian agriculture, and in your book, the problems are divided into four parts. Number one, it is environmental problem. Number two, it is institutional problem. Number three, economic problem. And last but not the least, it is that technological problem. So let's move on to the first point, that is environmental problem. So by this name, you can easily understand that environmental problem means the problem that is related to some environmental issues, right? And under this, there are so many sub points. So number one sub point is unreliable monsoon rainfall. So what is this unreliable monsoon rainfall? Like, as we know that Indian climate is highly influenced by monsoon wind and monsoon rainfall. But the monsoon rainfall is very erratic in nature. That means we cannot predict the actual arrival and withdrawal time of the monsoon as well as the amount of monsoon. And throughout our country, the distribution of monsoon is also not the same. So farmers, they generally can't rely on such monsoon rainfall. So if the monsoon rainfall will not be reliable, then what will happen? The productivity of the crops will be affected. So this also happens in our agriculture, and that's what it is causes. It is caused the huge amount of less production in India. Number two point is lack of irrigation facilities. Now, if we cannot rely on this natural source of rainfall or natural source of water, then what we will rely on? We have to rely on irrigation system. Irrigation system means artificially the land should be watered. Now, the farmers in India, they are literally poor and uneducated. They don't know how to give or how to spread the proper amount of water to the land. But the government, they help the farmers too much, and now they have allowed the farmers to take out the proper amount of water from the underground water and to spread the water over the agricultural field. But as I told you, the farmers, they are not so efficient. They don't know how to spread the water and how much or what is the particular amount of water need to take out for this. So because of this lack of efficiency, they take out more amount of water, and then when they spread more amount of water, it also affects the crops over the land, and it also affects the underground water table. And like this, the productivity of agricultural land is getting affected. Number three point, it is soil erosion. As you know, soil erosion means the quality of the soil will be degraded. Soil will be washed out. Okay, so what is the basic causes for soil erosion? Number one, it is deforestation or cutting down of trees. Number two, it is overgrazing. And number three, it is industrialization and so on. So these are the basic causes for soil erosion. They generally lower down the quality of the soil, and like this, the productivity of the soil is also getting hampered. So when the productivity and quality of the soil will be hampered, this will obviously affect the crops that is shown inside the soil. So that is one of the major problems related to Indian agriculture, that Indian agricultural fields, it is affecting by soil erosion and so on. Number two important problem is institutional problems. What is that institutional problems? Now here I want to give you one example. One farmer, suppose he was 80 years old. Okay, so before his death, he made a will, and there he distributed or segregated his property to his children. Okay, so in our country, in our culture, it is highly applicable till now that we will carry the property generation wise. Okay, suppose my father, he has certain amount of property after his death. If I am a son, then I'll be able to take it. So the farmer, he is 80 years old, and after he had 10 acres of agricultural land. Now after his death, what happened? This 10 acres land is getting divided into two parts, and son number one, he got 5 acres, son number two got 5 acres. Again, when son number one will die, he will distribute this 5 acres of land among his children. Suppose he had three children. Then what will happen? 5 acre land will be subdivided or will be distributed among these three children. And if he will divide 5 by 3, then each child will get 2 point something of land. Okay, son number two will also do the same. He will also distribute his land, his 5 acre land among his children. So like this here, we can see that from 10 acre of land, now the amount of land is 2 acre or 2 point something acre. So what will happen in our culture, in our agriculture, like our society, like this, the land or the land holdings is getting segregated and fragmented. So that's what it is written there, small and fragmented land holdings. Land holdings means nothing but a space, a piece of land, and then when it will be divided into so many parts. Suppose previously it was 10 acre. Now after segregation, after fragmentation, it has come to 2 acre. And on the very small land holdings, generally the modern technology cannot be applied properly. The machineries will not work properly, the other equipments will also not work properly. And if the modern technology will not be able to work properly, then obviously the production will be lower down. So this is the major cause or major problem related to institutional problems. Number three, that is economic problem. Now by this you can also understand what is it. Number one point, the farmers of India, they are very much poor. They cannot purchase that fertilizers, insecticides and so on. The chemical fertilizer, it is really cost effective, and they cannot buy this, and they cannot apply this on their field. So that is the one problem. Number two, they cannot hire so much high technology or modern technology. Okay, that's why still now they are dependent on old and primitive mode of agriculture. So that's what the agricultural productivity is not getting that much, is not getting affected, and it is degraded day by day. Number two, the subsistence type of farming. What is the meaning of subsistence type? That means the farmers, they will produce some crops, and after the production, they will only consume it. So in subsistence farming, surplus of production generally does not take place. When surplus or extra will not be produce, then this extra the farmers will not be able to sell in the market. So here the selling part is completely unavailable. So that's what the farmer, they cannot they cannot sell that extra product, and for this their income remains very low, and they consume their own foods. Okay, so they are suffering from such economic problems. Number four, that is technological problems. What is that technological problems? Obviously related to technology. As I told you, still in our country, farmers, they are mostly dependent on obsolete type of farming. What is the meaning of obsolete? The old and primitive method of farming. They don't like to use the machineries and other type of modern equipment. They still depend on bulls and on manpower to produce the crops, but this will not this cannot be produced so many crops. So that's what the agricultural productivity is very less in our country. So these are the basic problems that is related to Indian agriculture. I hope you have understood. So after this class, I told you that I'll mention some questions, and I hope that you all will do that. So the next part, that is Green Revolution, we will discuss it in our next video. Till then, thank you and take care.